top 20 on our big country countdown. And now for all the guys out of McConnell Air Base, here's another country classic.
You have a right to remain silent. If you give up the right to remain silent, anything you say, wise choice.
Brenda.
Nice.
Report of a disturbance, Sergeant Stark?
Yeah, one of the patrons came at me in a hostile manner.
Any reason?
He didn't care for my Valentine.
That's all?
No, he said something like roses are red, violets are blue, and a couple other things that didn't rhyme. Book 'em.
What's the charge?
Public nuisance.
Again? To keep this penthouse for myself.
You already bought a villa on the golf course. Shouldn't you exercise a little caution?
I intend to have this hotel plus the other two within 2 months, Draper.
I believe you two have only met by phone. Tom Stan Lorenzo, Tom Hampton. The mover and shaker from Chicago.
We'll see, won't we?
Gentlemen.
No, I have to fly back to New York.
How's everything, Ashley?
Oh, fine, Al. And you?
Could not be better.
Great. Excuse me. Just think, in a couple days, you'll be in Los Angeles. To a very good friend. To one hell of a dancer.
One hell of a night. The arrangements are made. Any questions? When? Soon.
Well, I think we all look smashing tonight. Don't you think we look smashing?
Yeah, smashing.
We should have a picture of this. Did you bring your camera?
Yeah.
Well, here we are.
Okay, I'll have to put a new roll of film in there. Look, why don't we take it over by the piano? There's better light. Excuse me, could you take a picture of us? Thank you.
To the three of us.
Thank you.
invited to meet the ladies down this afternoon.
I'll join you in a few minutes.
Good.
Ladies. Mr. Hefton, Mr. Draper, I'd like to introduce Kim Parker, Ashley Walters, and Laura Stark.
So the cab will be here in just a few minutes.
Okay. I'm not very good about saying goodbyes.
Neither am I. After a while, all the goodbyes add up to too many, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm going solo for a while. Getting another apartment, things like that.
I think that night at the penthouse was harder on you than it was on me.
You don't have to do that sort of thing, Laura. Not ever. So you remember that, okay? Before it's too late and you don't have a chance to make another choice.
Okay. In 15 minutes. Yes, I have the negatives. You just be sure to come up with the full amount as we agreed. No, there'll be someone with me, but she's not involved. It's just me.
Your taxi's here, Kim.
Come see us, Ashley.
Laura!
You forgot the Valentine for your brother.
Oh.
I miss you, Ashley.
Bye.
So hurry, Kim. Our plane doesn't leave for an hour.
We have a stop to make, a little side deal I have cooking.
Well, what kind of deal?
Extra money.
That movie producer in L.A. doesn't come through, we're going to need cash. Lots of it.
Hey, Stark, is the hospital full? This guy's bleeding all over the place. Any messages, Lawkinson's calls for me?
Oh, no calls,
Emmett. No calls, great.
Poke this at him, Henry, will you?
He poked his horse pistol in the drive-through window of McLean's Mighty Bite.
He should be in an emergency room.
Listen, I'm on a jet to Vegas in an hour, and he's in a verbal mood, aren't you, sport?
I'm wounded, man. I need a doctor.
Okay.
I need a doctor.
You need a seat.
No!
Listen to me, man. If I'd aim where I wanted to, you'd be pressing marble and I'd be on my way to Vegas. Now, if I have to stick around here and miss my plane...
No! What do you want to know?
Don't talk to me. Talk to him!
Chief wants to see you, Stark.
Now,
Stark, it's an improper arrest. The charges will be dropped because he didn't get...
He's probably wanted elsewhere. And those charges will hold.
Come on, Stark. Go me, Chief.
Hey, who is she? Get up there. Yeah, what do you want?
Close the door.
I don't have much time, Chief.
Neither do I. Close the door, have a seat. How'd you mess up that hand?
Suspect stomped on it.
With his face, I hear. In a barroom brawl off duty. You know, Stark, your drinking problem's becoming famous. Now, I know that it's supposed to be an occupational hazard for cops, but not in my department.
My tie on straight, Chief.
We have a major case coming to trial next week based on evidence that you spent 2 years putting together. The DA wants a sober-looking sergeant on the stand.
Polish my shoes. I'll go to a hairdresser.
Eyes clear, no booze on
the... I'll get a new mouthwash.
You know, you're a good detective, Stark, but we can't live without you.
You want my damn badge back?
What the hell's the matter with you, Evan?
My sister. I think something's happened to her.
Laura?
Yeah.
You think or you know?
Every Valentine's Day, we send each other a card or call each other. This year, I didn't get either. My card came back.
As I recall, you two didn't exactly make peace when she left for Vegas.
Phone's disconnected. There's no forwarding address. I'll tell you, Chief, something's happened to her. I'm on a plane out of here in 45 minutes to Vegas.
Are you serious? Just turn it over to the Vegas authorities. It's their turn.
I got 2 weeks accumulated overtime, Chief. I'm taking it.
You got a trial next week.
Ask the DA for continuance. Chief!
Tim. She's my sister. The only family I got. What would you do?
Okay, Evan, you got 10 days.
Thanks, Chief.
10 days, Max.
Yup. You got lucky on your suspect, Stark. He's wanted in Hutchinson and Topeka.
Yeah, as long as this calls for me.
Yeah, nothing.
Hey, Stark! You ever been to Vegas? Yeah.
Yeah, I want to talk to one of the girls in the chorus. Only take a minute.
Sorry. Nobody's admitted till showtime.
I see.
Hey, Al. Looks like that vacation agreed with you.
Yeah, I had a good time. What was that about?
Usual. He wanted to talk to one of the girls.
Anyway, why don't you take your break, then?
Okay.
How many times do you have to be told?
Not many.
Hey! How much you say this room is?
Sergeant Stark?
Yeah,
Ron Bliss.
Oh, nice to meet you, Lieutenant. What do you got for me?
I ran a bus and airline check after you called. And your sister had a plane ticket to L.A., which she didn't use. And neither did Kim Parker, who made the reservations.
Lieutenant Devon, line four.
That doesn't necessarily mean foul play. L.A.'s only 6 hours by car. They could have caught a ride.
You expect me to buy that, Lieutenant?
Well, unless you know where they might be in L.A., I can run a missing persons report.
No, not yet. I want to talk to the roommate, Ashley Wolf. Has he got her address?
That's restricted information. She's a casino employee.
Lieutenant, I'm a police officer.
Who's not here on official business. Our rules are a little stricter than you might think. And you're just another citizen here, and I'd like you to keep that in mind.
I'll try. The two girls seem to have fallen down a hole out here.
I checked the coroner's office.
Sergeant
and you can relax on that score.
Can I?
Well, where are you staying if any info turns up?
Mirage Motel.
That's in Vegas?
Barely. It's a real bargain for only $75 a day.
Patrol person Claire Brown. Please report to the watch commander. Patrol person Claire Brown.
You have room right here for a new wing on the hotel. Come on in, Al. Have a drink.
Thanks. Sounds good.
How was the vacation? Relaxing?
You bet.
There's nothing more relaxing than having your expenses all paid for.
You've earned it. There may be a bonus for you, too. There's a managerial position opening up in the security division of our casinos. Your name's at the top of the list.
I really appreciate you considering me, Mr. Hefton.
We take care of our own.
By the way, Al, the Kim Parker photos are on the bar. We were waiting for you to get back. Make sure they're all there, then burn them.
Now, of course, I'm not an architect, but it seems to me this wing can be bid competitively, so your cost run will not be more than anticipated. You should be able to break ground within a matter of months. Our people run this by for you, but you get...
What's the problem?
Nothing.
I just thought...
You thought what, Al?
Well, I...
Don't dance with us, Al. What is it?
I remember another picture of all the three girls together, but it's probably not even important anyway.
Any picture of that night is important, Al.
I don't think you understand our vulnerability, the personalities involved in the purchase of three casinos.
Give me a day or two. I think I know where it is.
Al, what we're saying here is, if this is too much for you, I have some personnel in Chicago available to us. They know what to do.
I'll find the photo for you.
I was expecting problems, but not of this magnitude.
Like this, and I'll be able to take you away from all this, Ashley, after my sprawl in 10 acres.
Keep me barefoot and pregnant?
Heck no, I'd buy you some shoes.
Gotcha this time, lady fingers.
It's almost the end of her shift. She's averaging over 70 hands an hour at a full table.
Here, baby. See you in a few days.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Your history, Ashley.
Ashley, you buy a cup of coffee?
It's against House rule.
Well, then how about on one of your nights off?
I'm not seeing anyone. It was my
Yes, hello. This is Ashley Walters. I live at 5439 Red Desert Lane. Someone just tried to break into my apartment. No, I didn't get a good look at him. I just saw the top of his head as he tried to get through the wind. No, nothing was taken. Tomorrow? Well, how soon can I... someone be patrolling the area? All right, thank you. Yes, that'll help me sleep better tonight. Yes, good night.
You were finished.
Oh, I saw you over there watching, waiting to take advantage of an old lady.
I'll tell you what. If I hit, you owe me a quarter.
Stay away from my slot, Buster.
You're late. Not again.
Police department. I'm serving papers on one of the girls in the chorus right now.
All right, girl. Try it again. Two, one, two, three, and cross. Two, one, two, three, four, cross. Two, no! No! Unbelievable. Well, what do you think? All I'm trying to do is put a new number into the show, a very simple step. I could train dolphins faster. Well?
I'm a police officer.
A police officer? It's very nice. Would you like to arrest someone? Could I pick them out? We have quite a few in arrested development already.
Could anybody tell me where I could find Laura Stark? She's my sister.
Laura? You have a very talented sister. I wish she were here. She could do this number to perfection. So could Kim.
Any idea where they went?
They fell under the spell of a producer, a casting agency, the Nancy Tabor Agency in the land of broken dreams.
Los Angeles.
What about Ashley Walters?
She quit too. Now I'm really depressed. What is this?
Sorry, Mr. Dukes.
Okay, fella, this time you're leaving for good. And quietly.
The name is Stark. Sergeant Stark. Homicide. I'm not user-friendly, and the only thing I hate worse than Vegas is imitation cops and tailored shirts. Step aside.
Try the mints if you want to talk to Ashley. She's dealing blackjack, hon.
Thanks. All right, girl. Let's try it again.
You're gonna bring some pension plan.
Only when you're winning.
Tried to break into my apartment. Look at his hand. I recognize his watch.
Dumb. It's a little early for your break, isn't it?
Security is on its way.
What's the matter with you?
Hey!
All right, pal. Come on.
Coming with us, take sir. Quietly, I hope.
It's all yours.
Come on, pal. Let's go. Got it.
We have a cigarette machine down the hall.
I don't smoke. No charges against me, I assume.
Oh, boy, you sure make it sound easy. Is that the way they do it back in Kansas? Got a few facts here. Somebody did try to break into Ashley Walters' apartment. They followed her home, and the description fits you right down to the wristwatch and the swollen left hand that she hit with a baseball bat.
She's confused. Will you give me her address, please?
Like I said before, that's restricted information, and particularly in your case.
Lieutenant, I called the casting agent and had the job for Laura and Kim Parker in L.A. She did not show.
I'll put out a missing persons report immediately.
Fine, good. You do whatever you have to do.
Where are you headed now?
I don't know. As they say in Kansas, I'm going to let my feet do the voting.
Well, if it's any comfort to you, we're looking into this, and we're checking our sources on the street.
How do you trust anybody in a town where half the people wear sunglasses?
You've been here one day. You got yourself 86 to one casino, arrested in another. And if you don't get your act together, mister...
Then we can avoid all this if you just give me Ashley Walters' address.
Have a nice day, Sergeant.
Sergeant Daniels and Sergeant McLaren, please report to the captain's office. Sergeant Daniels and Sergeant McLaren, please report...
How have you been?
All right, good.
I invite you in, but I'm on my way to work.
And so am I. I just wanted to know if you ran across a package Kim may have left for me.
No, I haven't seen anything.
She was going to leave it in my office. I'm not sure what happened to it. If anything turns up...
I'll give you a call.
Hey, thanks a lot.
Sure.
Have a nice day.
Some identification or your driver's license, please.
How fast was I going, officer?
You're jaywalking, repeating traffic.
Listen, I'm a police officer from Kansas. How about a little professional courtesy?
And we see a lot of cops, Mr. Stark. You should know better.
Nevada Highway Patrol tracks down vicious jaywalkers, huh?
That's right. You're crossing a state highway, and you just flunked the attitude test.
$50.
I imagine you do things a little differently back in Kansas.
Yeah, you can cross the street just about anywhere for under $50.
You have a real nice day, sir.
I'm still waiting for one.
It's fine. It's firm. We can book him, right? No problem. Hey, look, Teddy, I don't want him packing his nose this time, baby. You hear me? Uh-huh. Hey, I don't need a drooler here. Right. All right. Tuesday. What are you, a magic act? I didn't hear you knock.
It was a soft knock. Sergeant Stark, homicide?
Lee Vogel. Soft knock, huh? Well, some of my best friends. Can I have a closer look at that thing, please? Kansas, the breadbasket of Russia. Nice.
My sister was a member of your chorus line, Laura Stark.
Oh, sure. I remember Laura. Sweet, sincere. Sincerity's important. You don't see a lot of that nowadays.
She and another one of your girls, Kim Parker, didn't show up at their next job in L.A.
Knowing Kim, they are not hurting for a place to sleep, you know?
Meaning?
Well, let's just say that she recycled her assets after hours. Look. I only work here, right? I mean, it was just scuttlebutt. Have you talked to Ashley Walters? Those three were roommates.
I don't have her new address.
Huh. Well, no problem. Let's see. We sent her a final check to 5439 Red Desert Lane.
You always give addresses out this freely?
Oh, no. You got me a little worried, though. See, I didn't know that Laura was traveling with Kim. I'm gonna tell you something, Sergeant. Your sister was one of those girls who really didn't belong here.
Thanks. I appreciate this.
What's his interest in this?
He's Laurie's brother. He's a homicide detective.
You're running out of time, Al.
Take deep breaths and try not to hyperventilate.
The cop, the Valentine. Oh, my gosh, I'm sorry.
No, it's all right. All I want to know is how to get in touch with Laura in L.A.
Oh, I don't know. I haven't heard from her, and I may not.
Why not?
I've had about 10 roommates over the years, and only two of them ever sent me more than a card.
Oh, see. So you and Laura weren't all that chummy, huh?
No, I didn't say that. We were good friends. Yeah, I remember how much she liked you. When you weren't preaching about the evils of Vegas and trying to drag her back to Kansas to go to college.
Anything wrong with that?
No, but you thought something was wrong with her.
Did you tell me something about the guy or guys that tried to break into your apartment?
One of them looked exactly like you.
Oh, yeah?
He even had a watch like yours.
You get a good look at him?
No, it was dark, and I was busy hitting his hand with a bat.
You ever been to Wichita?
No.
Police said he followed you home. You have a car?
Yeah, it was a pickup truck. Dark gray with these little lights on top.
The license number?
No, I didn't need the license number. It had a dark windshield.
Dark windshield?
Yeah.
What about Kim Parker? I understand she liked to entertain men after the show. You meet any of them?
What are you saying?
I'm saying she was a chorus girl.
Yeah, so was I. So was Laura. So that makes us all flatbackers, right?
I didn't say that.
Well, you didn't.
Hey, wait a minute. Look, what I'm trying to tell you is that those guys may be back. Can we go somewhere and talk?
No, get out of my way.
What am I doing?
Wait a minute, who's going to clean up this mess?
Yeah, this is Stark, room 43. Somebody just call. Well, what did he sound like? Was he a cowboy, a New Yorker, a businessman, what? Yeah. Oh, thanks anyway.
Start looking.
Wherever she's got pictures.
Photo albums.
All right. I'll check down here.
All right.
I'll check upstairs.
Thank you.
Over here. Call your friend.
No way, man.
I'm gonna shoot you in the head.
Sammy, come up here, man.
Are you quiet, Tarantino? Now, what'd you find?
Come on, Sammy. We're having a little conversation. All right, guys. Up against the rail. Assume the position. Yeah, I'd like to report a burglary, complete with burglars. 5439 Red Desert Lane. I'm holding him at gunpoint. My name is Sergeant Stark. I'm a police officer on vacation. All right, get up.
Oh, my phone hurts.
You too. Come on. Keep your hands on your head.
Easy, man.
Move it.
Ruined.
Don't get any blood on the carpet.
Sit down. Back against the couch.
Ow, man!
Is this the best Vegas can do? I'm going to play a little game. I'm going to ask you some questions, and you're going to give me some answers. And if you give me the right answers, I solemnly promise not to ram your head through the wall. But if you give me the wrong answers, you may hate losing so bad you may never be able to play again. First question. What were you looking for?
We were looking for pictures.
Pictures? You. What kind of pictures?
We don't know anything, man. We don't know any kind of pictures. Nothing. Anything.
Anything.
Anything, huh? Next question. Why? Come on in. It's open. It's all right. I'm a police officer from Kansas.
On vacation.
They're disarmed.
What's going on here, Stark?
I apprehended two local lawbreakers, Lieutenant, unassisted. How'd you get here so fast?
Oh, I just happened to be in the area. Heard your name come over the radio. I can't believe you. Two scrapes of the law. I really didn't think you'd go for three.
You didn't hear about my jaywalking ticket, huh?
I didn't take nothing, man.
No, nothing much. Just a glass key.
All right, take him on down.
What is going on here? What happened?
Ashley, I want you to see this.
What are you doing in my apartment?
Exhibit A, Exhibit B. Now, which hand took batting practice? That's a nice watch, Sam. That gives you the exact time to let burglars out of lockup.
Yeah, fine time for you, Stark.
Better take care of that nose.
Yeah, I'll see you later, man.
Burglars? How many people broke in here?
Oh, just those two. It's lucky you asked me to hang around. You should have heard him. It's lucky you didn't get a loud party complaint.
Did you get into this apartment?
You didn't let him in?
Ashley, I'm in no condition to be arrested.
That's what I thought. Come on, Stark. You're going downtown to join Sam and his friend.
Lieutenant, I did ask him to watch my place. I just forgot to give him a key.
Yeah, she forgot the key.
You been tipping a few?
I know my limit, Lieutenant.
You know mine? I'll take your gun, Sergeant.
You're kidding.
I don't kid about guns. You get it back in a few days as soon as I talk to your home office. You were carrying something down here the other day.
Oh, you mean my detective special? Those two Adam Henrys will be out on the street tomorrow, Lieutenant. What do you want me to do, throw donuts at them?
I suppose
suppose I should thank you.
I have no objections.
Thank you.
You want a drink?
I got a feeling that's why you're so divorced.
Well, if you're going to shower me with gratitude.
Please lock the door on your way out.
I'm merely glad to have been of some service, madam. In our humble duties, we expect little or no gratitude.
So how come you're not married, Lady Ashley, huh? Tell me that.
How'd she know I was divorced? I'm just a jaywalker from Kansas, looking for your spare gun.
Husband to be better than none at all. That's how come I'm not married.
I had some pants when I came in last night. I'm almost positive.
In the hall closet. Don't worry, your virginity is still intact.
I guess you've undressed a few.
Drunk? Oh, yes. My father was a drinker. So was my ex-husband. How do you like your eggs? Straight up?
How can you be so certain I'm so divorced?
You're a cop, aren't you? You drink, don't you?
Guilty, both counts.
And your socks don't match either.
They match the pair in my suitcase.
Who told you you could stay here last night?
Well, I figured that with what I drank, the streets would be safer without me. Oh, you know, Ashley, those guys that broke into your apartment, they weren't looking for jewels or money.
That's my seat.
They were looking for photos.
Photos?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of photos?
I don't know. What kind of photos do you keep around here?
Not the kind you're thinking of. Just some family albums, snapshots, things like that.
Well, I figure it has something to do with Laura or Kim or both. Can the girls take everything with them?
No. Kim mentioned something about a storage locker, but I don't know which one. How's the bacon?
Pretty darn good.
For a chorus girl?
For a divorcee.
Oh, that's what you wanted for Laura, isn't it? Marriage. 2.7 kids, a house in the suburbs overlooking a large mortgage.
Not necessarily. That's what my dad wanted.
She did love you, though. Quite a bit. Tell me something. How does a big bruiser like you get a name like Evan?
Well, when they named me, I was very small and adorable.
What happened?
Mentioned something about storage. I sent Laura some of her mother's jewelry. You know where she kept it?
She might have had a safety deposit box. We had the same bank.
Miss Stark will have to come in and personally authorize any information she once turned over to you. It's bank policy, brother or not.
I'm also a police officer.
That's a nice badge. I'm afraid regulations prevent us from accommodating you, Mr. Stark. Your sister will have to come in herself.
I told you my sister is missing.
Or you can get a court order, Mr. Stark.
I merely want to look into her safe deposit box. I don't want to steal it. She may be in some danger if we don't get a lead.
I, too, would be in jeopardy if I violated banking regulations. All I can say is, when you do find your sister, please advise her that she's overdue with her safe deposit box rental. It's rather expensive to open a box. If we're forced to, naturally, we expect the renter to pay for that.
I want to speak to your senior vice president.
I'm sorry, Mr. Stark. It was he who told me you could not open the safe deposit box without a court order. Now, as you can see, I...
I'll tell you what I'm going to do, Mr. Seymour. I'm going to get myself a court order. It's your bank, huh?
Bet you have a short Christmas card list.
Let's go find a judge.
Are you going to rough him up, too?
We gotta sit here and stare at this cactus.
And the man gets here with a new game plan.
And what the hell's he know how to do that we don't know how to do anyways?
He ain't on bail like we are.
This is absolutely exquisite.
Take a walk, man.
Have you taken the time to appreciate this?
Hey, beat it.
You should. Life is beautiful.
Hey, you got a problem?
Well, Laura was my kid's sister. And after our folks died in the accident, I was a rookie cop, and so I had to finish raising her. I raised a nice girl. She was like a puppy, used to follow me around. Became a pretty good cook, too, out of self-defense against my cooking, I might add. She made killer lasagna and spaghetti pie and chicken croquettes.
Spaghetti pie?
Yeah. You know, leftover spaghetti. You put it in the container, you put it in the icebox at night, take it out, put it in the oven, crisps up, got a crust on it, put it on the plate. Eat it, it's good.
I see. Did you remarry while she was with you?
Oh, no. I was having too much fun putting her through high school. I managed her soccer team. And I watched her dance in high school shows.
Is that how she came to Las Vegas, dancing?
Yeah. Well, she met this guy, went through his school, said he had connections out here. I had her enrolled at KU. We had an argument, and she left. I don't know what happened to the guy. I'm afraid that... I don't know what happened to her. I'm just afraid of him. It may be too late. It may be too damn late.
I think that the court can find a latitude of mercy that will allow you to continue your search, Sergeant. But within certain bounds.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Really snowed her, huh?
Yeah, those look like real tears.
Yeah.
Now we get to visit your favorite person, Mr. Seymour.
I gotta call Bliss, find out if he's got any stats on Mr. Mooks, tried to break into your place last night. Lieutenant Bliss, Sergeant Stark calling. He did? Where? Come on.
The yellow Chevy sedan of one.
Estimate from him, he puts it at 6 hours or less.
Who put up the bail?
Local bondsman named Plosterman. Won't tell us anything, can't.
22 in the temple. Fast, professional, and very sanitary.
I don't understand. These guys were after me and they get murdered?
Well, I would say that whoever hired them was trying to cover his own trail. Keep us from tying him to them. Sorry you have to see this. We're all on the same trail now, so any info that you have, I could use. Your chief back in Kansas says that you sustained more convictions than any cop in your county. He also said he'd like you back in a few days. If you need any protection, let me know. We're here to help.
The only reason you're still alive is that somebody thinks you've got some photos.
I don't understand.
Laura's dead.
I trust you understand everything must remain on the table.
Oh, there's some great pictures of Laura here. And of you, quite a few of you.
It's her birth certificate. Jewelry seems to be here. I like your aftershave, Mr. Seymour, but do you have to hover? I'm sorry. Soccer championship.
I trust you've seen everything you needed to see.
Uh-huh. I'd like to keep this one, Mr. Seymour. I think it's the last time I'll see my sister again. Alive.
You take it, Mr. Stark.
Contrary to previous opinion, Seymour, you're all right.
When did you get back?
When I knocked over the box. $1,000 or more in $100 bills. You have any idea how Laura came by this? Well, Trans Allied Storage Company, 3300 Rio Road. You know what that is?
I think so. Why would Kim's key be in Laura's box?
Safest place in the world. Safe deposit box of a close friend who didn't know why and wouldn't ask questions. We're gonna have to break in there tonight.
What are you talking about? Those places have attack dogs and high fences, guards with guns.
Dogs?
Yeah, and high fences and guards with guns.
Dogs.
I don't know why we're here, but whatever it is, I don't
like
it.
Lock the door. Don't come out until I'm back.
Well, what if you don't come back? Those guys hate cops.
Right. My blood type, O negative.
Thank you.
I'd like some of your better brown water with a beer back.
Hey, Hector. How much you give me for a tin star?
Well, that's very observant, Grubby. Hi. I'm a detective.
And you just came in here for a drink?
No, I'm not local. I'm from Wichita. Kansas. I'm here on a personal errand. I want to buy some Reds.
And we look like pharmacists.
I need some powerful downers for a friend.
Well, that's illegal.
Ah, yeah.
We're talking about a controlled substance. Mm-hmm. Well, I'll tell you what, Wichita. If you can put my friend Rhino on his butt, someone might be able to fill that prescription.
Rhino.
Scurvy wants you to dump a cop. Like Wichita's gonna do a little dance with the rhino for his downers.
Greco-Roman wrestling, just like in the Olympics. Which means no punching, no chair swinging, rhino, no ear biting.
Okay, rhino.
Let's go.
Guy was stronger than 7 inches of garlic.
You're bleeding.
Well, bless their ugly hearts. They filled my order.
If I'd have known you wanted barbiturates, I would have gotten you a prescription.
Uh-huh.
Here, dog. Here, dog.
It's gonna take a while for the tranquilizers to work on the dogs.
I've been wanting to do that ever since I found out you were Laura's brother. She always told me I'd like you. She was wrong, but...
Be right back.
Thank you.
See the barbed wire.
David Johnston, 8350 Cottonwood Lane, Newton, Kansas. You know this guy?
No.
James Davis, Albuquerque, New Mexico. What about him?
No.
I'm glad Laura isn't in any of these pictures. You lived with Kim for 2 years. You didn't know this was happening?
Well, I knew she might have been moonlighting, but nothing like this. How could you be so sure that she was blackmailing?
The name of every guy is on the back of the picture with the address and the date. They look very married and vulnerable, wouldn't you say? All she had to do was send one little threatening note and they'd ante up.
She wore better clothes and ate out a little bit more than the rest of us, but, you know, no expensive car or furs or anything.
She was a smart girl, Kim. But she had to know somebody, some guy, some girl she was working with. I knew those poor suckers, and they set them up.
It's been a long day.
did I do, snore?
No. No, it's something I did. You should know about it. It may have some bearing.
I'm awake, I think.
A few nights before Laura and Kim left for Los Angeles, we were invited to a penthouse to entertain three businessmen.
Entertain?
We were paid $1,000 each.
Laura?
It was her first time. Mine too. That's how she came by those $100 bills that you found in that envelope.
Okay. I didn't sleep with a virgin last night.
A hooker. I slept with this man named Tom, who was a real estate developer from Chicago, and Laura was with a guy named Jeff. And Kim wanted Tom, but she ended up with a man named Stan.
Okay, okay, what's the bearing?
Well, the bearing is that I think this guy, Al Connor, arranged it.
Al Connor? Kim's boyfriend?
No, he's just a friend. He, in hotel security. He was always talking to her privately after we came off stage. Anyway, that night at the party, Kim had her camera with her, and she took some pictures, but I can't find any of them in this pile. And then Al Connor came by my apartment and asked if Kim had left a package for him.
Why would she take her camera to the party? Who were they blackmailing?
Well, Kim always had her camera with her. In fact, I asked her to take a picture of Laura and me that night because we looked so smashing. And so Kim changed the roll of film, and then she asked this guy to take a picture of the three of us. You know, sort of a goodbye shot.
There's film in this camera.
So?
So?
So what do you think of me now?
I'll drive you to work. Mr. Reinhardt, I'm Evan Stark, the guy who called.
Be right with you. Joey, invite Dad Burnett at the bar and the disposable shorts to vacate the premises. Give her cab fare if she claims she needs it. What can I do for you, Stark?
I understand Al Connor works here.
Yeah, he's one of the new supervisors. Excuse me. Mr. Risley, this is Chip Reinhardt. I think we've got a dauber on number three table.
The one with the glasses. His right hand. What's a dauber?
Card marker. Uses luminous paint, keeps behind his ears, sometimes in his hair. Wear special glasses to pick up the glow.
It's a guy on monitors at four. Looks like he's packing a gun.
One of ours, but thanks anyway. What do you want with Al Connor?
Want to talk to him?
Well, when you do, be polite.
Why's that?
Yeah, it's a fair-haired boy, Tom Hefton.
Hefton? The real estate developer?
From Chicago. Hefton's taken over this casino and two others in a week or two. Knows nothing about the business.
How does a Connor connect with a Hefton?
I don't know, but the word around here is don't bother Connor. My hunch is he'll be taking over this casino in a month.
Where can I find him?
Far end of the blackjack pits. Jacob, there's a lady on table six bending cards. She's harmless, but the other guys may be picking up on her crimps. Yeah, the one with the jewels. Right.
Paging Mr. Balkan. Please pick up the house call. Mr. Balkan.
Hey, Al.
Please. House
Al Connor, isn't it? My name is
Sergeant Stark. What can I do for you, Sergeant?
Well, I'm looking for my sister, Laura. I understand you were a friend of her roommate, Kim Parker.
Kim Parker?
That's right.
Oh, yeah. Dancer.
Also something of a photographer.
Am I right? I wouldn't know that. She had quite a body, though.
You know where I could find her?
Yeah, she and Laura went to L.A.
You sure of that?
Yeah.
When was the last time you saw Kim? At the penthouse?
Will we continue to stalk some other...
Sure, time? When?
Give me your phone number. We can meet...
You already got my phone number. You gave it to Sam and Dino. We don't need it anymore.
I've got work to do, if you don't mind.
Hey, Al. See you around.
Mr. Blue, the card room, please.
Listen, when are you coming back? You're missing all this beautiful weather down here. We got 7 inches of fresh slush.
Yeah, soon. Listen, Chief, I need a favor. Could you run a CNC on a real estate developer from Chicago? His name is Thomas Hefton. He's buying up 3 casinos out here. I think I stumbled onto something.
It's got something to do with Laura?
I think so.
Huh. Well, what'd you find out?
Laura's dead.
I'll find out what I can. Call me back in a while. Evan?
Yeah?
I'm real sorry, kid.
You're not worried?
No. You can get back to work, Al. The man from Chicago will clean up your mess.
My mess? You wanted the girls that night.
We could have done without Kim's little blackmail scheme, Al.
Hey, I was the one who told you about the other photo. And how's this Powell guy going to clean up things if he doesn't know where the picture is?
If he doesn't find that picture, I would imagine he'll make certain that no one else does. And now I have some work to do. How long?
5 minutes.
Your legs on stage at the Dunes last year?
It's possible. My legs were there.
Your hands are lovely, too.
Thank you. They're also dealing cards. Go back.
Did you run a credit and criminal check?
Everything. Tom Hefton can run for bump. He's a plenty squeaks.
What's this all about?
I'll let you know.
I'll hold you to that. Evan.
Yeah?
This is personal for me, too.
Yeah. Chief, thanks for this. Be speaking to you.
Beautiful moon. Right age. Such a pity.
Beg your pardon?
You wouldn't understand.
Today. I need clothes.
It's
I need
too risky.
I can't live out of my purse.
Buy some clothes on the way to the motel.
You still think we should be together tonight?
We have no choice. Let's get something to eat.
Would you like a glass of wine or some beer?
No.
A cocktail, perhaps?
Call you.
You haven't said how you feel.
About what?
About what I told you.
Why'd you quit the chorus?
I decided that it was time for me to make some choices in my life instead of taking what was being offered. The night in the penthouse was the low point of my life. If you can believe that. The $1,500 was only money to break away
from. Wait a minute. $1,500? I thought it was a grand.
He added a tip.
Tip, huh?
Oh, I know. You're thinking you haven't seen $1,500 worth, huh?
Thinking that if this is the guy that paid you $1,500, he can afford it.
It's him, all right.
I guess he had a pretty good look at him.
Are you going to keep this up? Because if you are, I'll take my chances with Lieutenant
And this Fritz. Other guy, Draper, he had his fun with Laura?
It was her first time, Stark, her only time. And I don't see why we have to be so ashamed either. I mean, come on, you men go out and pick up what's ever on a corner. Can we get on by this, please, Sergeant? And tell me something. What is so risky about my stopping by my apartment for 5 minutes? Just 5 minutes. I can grab enough clothes for a week. It is broad daylight out there.
5 minutes. 5 minutes and only 5 minutes. Another 20 minutes for the photos. It's a nice day.
I don't feel safe any place. I think it's time I got out of Vegas.
That's an understatement. Where would you go?
Back to college?
Well, they say you're never too young. Pluses and minuses.
And just what is the noble Evan Stark going to do? Be a macho cop all of his life?
Why not? That's where I shine. Don't you think I shine?
It depends on which way you're facing. You do have a protective side to you.
They look like old buddies.
Stan Lorenzo.
And Epson's buying 3 casinos next week.
With syndicate money, it would seem.
Stark, you turn that photo over to Vegas Police Lieutenant Bliss. I don't care how personal this is.
Bliss called you, huh?
Yeah. He says you're getting in over your head, you wind up in a landfill, not be able to testify next week.
And the DA wants a clean-cut, extra-sober detective on that stand. You hear me? What was that?
Extra sober breath. As they say out here, have a nice day, Chief. We're going back to the photo store. Have this blown to 8x10 with copies.
Why?
Seems your friend Kim Parker did a little blackmail number on Tom Hefton. Sold him the other pictures you were talking about. Now that's why Laura and Kim are dead. But what she didn't realize is that when this picture was taken, Lorenzo and Hefton were in the background. Now, the Nevada Gaming Commission meets tomorrow to rule on the suitability of Hefton as a casino owner. If they had any suspicion he was fronting for an organized crime capo, they'd deny him a license.
This one little photo could just blow a $1 billion deal?
This one little photo and the 3 people who knew about it.
Who's the third?
Al Connor. To catch you while you're still breathing, Al.
You got a problem, Stark?
Nothing compared to what you got. You're pure sleaze, Al. Feeding 2 girls to the mob for your sleazy little blackmail scam.
What are you talking about? Kim pulled a pin on herself trying to blackmail Hefton. I didn't know what she was doing.
Killed my sister.
No! Sammy and Dito did.
Who gave the order? Listen to me. I want to know. Was it quick? Did Laura know it was coming? Putting a snail pellet through your brain pan, Al, will look like suicide. We'll dedicate it to Laura.
Draper! Draper gave the kill order.
Jeff Draper, the lawyer?
Yeah, he's Lorenzo's right arm out here. He freaked out when he saw the photos of Lorenzo and Tom Hefton.
Who took out Sammy and Dino?
Draper brought him from back east, Powell. I didn't even know until after it happened.
You're the memory bank on 4 murders, Al. After the Gaming Commission meets tomorrow, you're dog meat. Unless you turn state's evidence, you understand?
How long do you think I'd live?
At least somebody will to keep you alive.
Who's going to keep you alive?
One is left.
With one picture.
All right, the sooner you give it to me, the safer you're gonna be. Because that shooter doesn't miss.
So I noticed.
Stay back over here, Bob. Give us the movie.
You know, you could have taken that slug and not your pistol. Give me the phone.
Tomorrow at the gaming commission.
You're under my jurisdiction, mister.
So is my sister.
Yeah. A call just came in for you. Your friend Stark was involved in a shooting incident. He's at the hospital.
Well,
she didn't say anything, what?
All I know is I gave her the message about you in the hospital, and she ran out of here, and that's the last we saw
her. This is what I want you to do. Call the police department, Lieutenant Bliss. Tell them I've gone after the photo. Lieutenant Bliss, you got it?
Lieutenant Bliss.
All right.
Off Highway 31 is a dry lake bed.
I want to talk to her.
Bring the photo and the negative.
Now, wait a minute. Listen to me. You want me to come out there alone and meet your army?
You'll be able to see if there's anybody there. It's desert.
And we'll be able to see you, too. Don't be clever, because we'll kill her. It's going to take me a while to get these photos. I'm not coming out there at night.
Daybreak. No later. And I do mean no later.
Bliss, but one of your rookies could muck it up.
What if you muck it up?
You'll have two more murder charges. Have a nice day.
It's night.
He's alone.
Either he's stupid or we are.
He's from Kansas. He trusts people.
I want to see her. Photo, please. Untie her. You better have that photo. Oh, I got the photo all right. In case you're unfamiliar with this stuff, this is bunker stick. Enough to turn this part of the dry lake bed into a fine football stadium.
I like your style, Stark. All brass, huh? You wouldn't mind if I had a look at that dynamite, would you?
Not at all, buddy.
What are you doing?
We're having a look. Welcome to Ground Zero, gentlemen. I'll have your gun. Ashley, get in the car.
Shoot, you idiot! He's wearing dynamite!
dynamite. You'll blow us all away.
Ashley, get in the motor home. Go ahead.
You drive.
What do you say we camp here for a while?
Right now, I'd like a cigarette.
Yeah, I could use one.
Where are you going here?
How are you doing?
Hello.
So, you followed me after all, huh?
I like you, Stark. You're a fun guy to be with.
What about the photo?
It was delivered to the Gaming Commission. Hefner won't be buying a lot of hotels with murder charges against them. Get him.
Oh, get him. Get a hold of him there.
All right, come on.
Okay. Get him. Get him.
Evan, it's over. So what's next?
Back to Wichita. Have to testify at a trial this week. What about you?
I'm enrolled at the university.
In Vegas?
They have one of the best hotel management programs in the country.
You gonna manage hotels?
I thought I'd start with one.
Well, from what I've seen, you can manage just about anything.
Even you. If you could find your way back to Vegas.
Maybe you could find your way to Wichita.
What would I do in Wichita?
What would I do in Vegas?
Are we gonna have another argument?
I'd rather have a beer.
A beer?
One beer.
One beer.
And then, some dinner.
Some dinner.
Then start something.
We can finish.